All right, our guest today is known for his heartbreaking ballads, and he's kind enough to take time from his Blames on Me tour to stop by the Fresh Out Live studio for the first time ever. Hailing all the way from Canada, please welcome singer and songwriter, Alexander Stewart.
Hey man, how are you?
How's it going?
We're old friends, y'all.
You know what's crazy? Is like, you know, people come here all the time when they do shows, but you brought your fans from the show. Like, we got merch right here. You can't see it at home.
Let's go.
Blames on Me.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm great.
How was the show?
So many familiar faces. Oh my gosh.
The reviews are in, dude. You're a hit in New York.
Y'all, it was so crazy. I played my first ever New York show like 2 days ago. The loudest crowd by far for any of the shows I've done ever. So. Something in the air here.
I'm from here.
Something
we're
in the
crazy.
Air. No, it was the best. Horizon. Made me feel really special.
What I told you backstage is like, we're real here in New York City. So if we like you, we're gonna let you know. If we don't like you, we'll also let you know.
Oh,
but
God.
They love you, dude.
If they don't like you, just ignore them.
Yeah, exactly. So dude, tell me about Leave Me in the Dark. I wanna talk about this first and foremost before we get
absolutely.
There and everything else. And how did this whole thing come to be?
Well, I wrote this song like probably about 3 months ago, and it's about like a nice little toxic relationship.
Right.
And nothing was ever perfect, and by the end of it, there was never a goodbye. It was kind of just left on like a...
The worst.
I was like, this is how I feel, and then I got nothing back and never... And that's fine, like, whatever, it happens, it definitely happens, but it inspired a lot of music.
Right, it led to a great song, I mean, forget about it.
Yes.
I'm so curious to ask any artist, specifically you, when do you know that a song is done? Because we always get the finished product, we love it, right? But it's like, when do you put like the final stamp on it?
I mean, that's such a tricky question, because like art is so, so subjective, not only for like the artist, but for everyone listening to it.
Totally.
So it's like, a lot of the time, I don't know that it's done. It's just kind of like a feeling. Or like, I really gotta put this out at some point.
Well, so. Are you somebody who's like really hands-on with like the mix and stuff like that?
Totally, I mean,
yeah.
Absolutely. When I go in to write these songs, I always start completely from scratch because I just can't go in. I don't wanna write to a track. I really like writing my own music.
Yeah.
I have to be a part of like everything along the way. And then once actually it's like my baby. I'm like, okay.
Now, do we have any longtime fans in the house? That's good. Old, new, we got everybody in the house. Now you started doing these like covers on YouTube, and that's how a lot of artists, you know, have broken over the past 10, 15 years, right?
Yeah.
Bieber, fellow, you know, Toronto, and did that. When did you make this transition, and how did you make that transition to writing your own stuff?
Yeah, I mean, I'm from Toronto, and like, I really did not like school at all. And so like, I'm like, trying to figure out, I'm like, how do I, as a 16-year-old, like, get myself into the music industry? I don't know, but like, at the same time, there was Justin Bieber and Shawn Mendes and Charlie Puth and all these covers on YouTube. And I was like, I could do that, probably. I don't know. So I like put my first one up, it got like 100 views, and I was like, I've done it. This
I'm
is
a
it.
Pop star.
This is it. And I just continued that for so long.
Yeah.
For like 2 years until finally I was like, I'm gonna do it. And the whole goal the whole time was to make original music. But
here
like
you are, dude.
Here I am, so I don't know.
Blames on Me tour. Now, you know, especially on a tour where you're doing cities for the first time, rooms for the first time, it's both exhilarating, but it's a learning experience for an artist, right?
Yeah.
What have been some of the takeaways from tour?
Oh my God, that nothing goes right ever. Like, the New York show, before you go on, there's like a thing called sound check, essentially, where you like, you have like inner monitors, and like what you hear, what the artist hears is totally different than what everyone else hears. We did it for an hour and a half, and nothing was going right at all. So like, right before I went on, I kind of was just like, please work.
Yeah.
Like ran on stage. And that's why sometimes you'll see artists like in the butt, they're like point to the back and they're like shooting up or they're like going down. Basically just like what you hear is so different. Sometimes you can't hear yourself. It's just crazy.
It's crazy.
Nothing goes right ever.
Well, clearly it came out awesome, right? I mean, for anyone that was there the other night, I mean, it was a huge show. You're also going on tour. I believe it's picking up in June. Charlie Puth, a round of applause. That's gonna be huge for Alexander. And thank you so much for coming by, dude. I wish we had more
thank
time to talk.
So
maybe back in LA, we'll hang out.
Absolutely.
All right. Check out the new single, of course, Leave Me in the Dark. This is Fresh Out Live. You guys have been amazing here in New York.